Morning, children. Hope all well. Now we haven't done. Children, please be a little aware of your classes. Last year, I feel that when we did this online classes, many of you were very, into it, very enthusiastic and all. But this time, I've noticed. Nobody sends me the lessons. Listen, children, I tell you that it is not for me. It is for you all, because school will open. Maybe, not today, not tomorrow, but another month, and I'm telling you, it'll open and you'll be at a loss because you will not know what's happening. So it is better that you do your work and listen to this video carefully. Now, we've been doing sentences. Last time I told you the difference between the sentences should start with a capital letter and end with a full stop. And also, it's a group of words and it has to make a complete sentence. You can't say, ma'am, toilet. No, ma'am, I would like to go to the toilet. Something like that. Then again, also I told you to do an exercise on page 8 about rearranging the words and phrases to make meaningful sentences. We have to make good sentences, because not only writing but speaking also to someone will help us. So we have done page 8, hopefully, I suppose, because I've corrected some books or WhatsApp. But then, like I told you, if you can come and leave your books in the in the office, I'll correct it. And the next day, because children, I saw you also that day when I was going for a walk, a whole lot of children going here, there, everywhere. Have you understood? So please, please do your work. Now look at page 9. I've already written, fill in the table. Now this is not this table, it's just a table like that, not this. With suitable subjects and verbs to complete these sentences. Now, subject. Now, what is a subject? I'm the subject. What am I doing? Teaching, taking an online class. And how am I? Is it interesting? The ma'am Sudha is taking an online class, which is very interesting, or something like that. Over here, it's written subject, the son. What is the subject? The topic. What are you going to say about is the subject. Verb is something doing. What is the subject doing? Like, what is the sun doing? The sun shines brightly. How does it shine? Brightly. So there is one table like this, you can see over here. Can you see this? It's over there. It, the sun shines brightly. Now when you do it in your copies, please don't draw this table. Have you understood? And you don't have to write. You can do it here, actually, once. You can do it in your reader with pencil. You write the date here. Don't forget, every page that you do, please write the date so that we know which page we are doing. So subject, verb, and what it's doing. Have you understood? And one has been done for you. The sun shines. Well, how does it shine? Brightly. Number 2. And now when you do it here once first, have you understood? And if you can show me this readers, I'll correct it. Then after I correct it, what you do is you should take a new page, and on the new page you'll write this B. What is written in B? Fill in the table with suitable subjects and verbs to complete these sentences. Like that on top, if you see, the sun brightly. You don't know what is the meaning. The sun shines brightly, that way. Now, when you finish in this book and you do your corrections, if you can give it to me, then after that, you take a new page in your copy, take a new page and you write the date. And then you write, first. You don't have to write subject, verb. You just write, fill in the table with suitable subjects and verbs to complete these sentences. Have you understood? That's it. Just till here. You don't have to write one has a. And then you write one. The sun shines brightly. Suppose the next one, I'm just going to go once with you so that you will know how to do it. Dash, dash in the garden. The gardener, now the gardener will be the subject. Verb will be, I'm just saying, is working in the garden. Number three, for the soldiers were awarded for their bravery. I planted flowers in the flower pot under the mango tree. Ram is sitting, verb will be, is sitting under the mango tree. Now, dash, dash, tired. Sita is feeling tired. Number seven. My mother, the subject is my mother. What is she doing? Verb is paying the bill. Have you understood? Number eight. You can say the teacher, that is the subject. The teacher can speak four languages. Come to number nine. Whatever name, you can give any name, like let's say Mary. Mary, you write in number nine, is going. What is the verb? Is going to play badminton. Number 10. The teacher is reading poetry. 11. Tom is the subject, verb is getting ready. You can write, verb is getting ready. What is he doing? He is getting ready for the party. Number 12 is, what is number 12? At the break of day, the cock crows, like, you know, oh, at the break of day, early in the morning you hear. So now you have understood. First you will do it in this table. Pencil, please don't use pens, nicely. Then in a new page you will write this B and you will do this. And leave a line after every sentence. Have you understood? Please leave a line. Now come to, very easy today, nothing much. Add suitable words to this group of words to make complete. Now if you see the sentence, you know, it is not complete. I have been what? I have been punished by my teacher. You can write that. Here also, you will do it here with your pencil, in pencil, and not with a pen. You write, and good writing, please, children. Like last time also, I wanted to tell you, like, let me see. Suppose I write the same thing in a sentence. I write one. The sun shines brightly. B-R-I-G. Now, if you see, children, there's spacing between the words. Here. Spacing between the words. Have you understood? And then you will leave a line and write the next sentence. Please do it neatly. You know, presentation is very, very important. Now when you finish that, you do this in your reader. Please do it neatly. Some of you are just doing it just to, you know, finish your work. Oh, I'm going to do it, that's it. No, you have to do it properly. Like suppose, and you have got a long weekend, so you can do it. You can start today itself and do it. I have been punished. You can write that. Riddhi informs Siddhi about the exam. The train leaves at 9 o'clock in the morning. Pragya's father jogs in the park. That boy has stolen my pencil box. At the bus stop, many people were waiting. I cannot see from here. The boys made fun of their teacher or made fun of their friends. Suni laughed very loudly. I shall not go to school today. That's what you all are saying every day. Bhushan knows how to do his homework. Ishita accepted her mistakes. Now, children, these two, once again, I'm telling you, page, what is it? 9. B and C. First, do it here. And then, after that, do it in your copy. I have told you to make one copy for English language and literature. I don't want any, some children are just bringing any copy, doing any way they want. No, I want you to do it in one copy and do it properly. Now, that is all. I'm not going to go into lengthy explanation because, sad to say, or you are not bothered to see it also. And then grammar is where you're going all wrong. So anyway, please do your homework. Bring it to school. I'm here because I come for my online classes. If you can come, you can come and meet me and give it, especially children who are here. Please, now don't be careless. Have you understood? So do your work and enjoy your day also, which you are doing every day because you have been really enjoying everything. So anyway, good morning and thank you, children. I'll see you again for your literature class.